This is the data for the kinetic energy activity in the static and kinetic friction lab. I should say kinetic friction activity. This is the last data set I took. The top graph is the force. The middle graph is kinetic energy, and don't worry about it. I just left it up there because I'm going to need it at some point here in the next activity. The bottom graph is the velocity. There's some spikes here just because the motion detector, I think, picked up my hand as I started moving the block. The square brackets show where I have averaged the data. And you can see those are the statistics that we took in the last lab. The mean value of the force in this region is 0.3514 newtons. Similarly, the data for the velocity shows a mean velocity of 0.2965 meters per second. I am going to now show you the data that I collected for the five data runs. And I attempted this several times more than five. Like I said, coordination does come into play, but these were the best five data sets I had. I started copying down the wrong number on the first velocity, so that value is up here. It's 0.1976 meters per second. I'm going to just leave the camera here for a minute before I stop the video. You will need to calculate the coefficient of kinetic friction for each trial. You will need to write the average here. Do not worry about the standard deviation. Just calculate an average for the coefficient of kinetic friction. Keep in mind that this is going to be an average. I said at the end of the last video, or maybe the one before that, I think, about the track not having a uniform smoothness. This is true. This is why these numbers have such variation in them. All we're doing here is calculating an average.